The cost to finish, the cost to cut bait. City Council learning today the real numbers if they derail this streetcar project. Good evening, I'm Mike Dardis.
And good evening to you, I'm Cherie Pallella. We're also learning tonight how big the bill will be if they finish it. WLWT News 5's John London live for us outside of City Hall tonight with those numbers and who is now supporting this project. John.
Well, it's all in which lens you use. Mayor John Cranley puts the cost to cancel at $30 million. Others read it as high as $80 million. The audit itself puts the total cost of continuation at nearly $106 million. But one number that may count the most is six. That's what it would take to override a John Cranley veto. The streetcar struggle has only intensified with today's audit numbers, which you can sift through on WLWT.com. They show canceling versus continuing roughly in the same ballpark as before, but they peg the operating cost gap at around $2 million a year. That's got the attention and likely streetcar support of the vice mayor.
Particularly with all the folks that are interested in working together to try to find a way to cover that.
It's got the certain veto of the mayor, who is unimpressed with Sorta's suggestions.
And the appointments that my predecessor made were people that were ideologically committed to the streetcar. So, I mean, they're doing what they believe.
More than 100 citizens spoke to the decision makers.
It's time for the streetcar to die.
Streetcar supporters stressing the return on investment, the resources expended so far. Opponents seeing elitism on steroids.
Newsflash. We've all made investments.
The real debate was happening away from the public eye among unnamed civic-minded folks with deep pockets.
Let's just say there's folks talking right now. I've been on the phone since I got here, and we're looking for a solution.
It is now down to whether some sort of collateral guarantee can sway Kevin Flynn by tomorrow's time to call the question. The budget for the basics still hanging in the air along the construction site.
I'm just afraid that it's going to cut into police, fire, bus service.
Also hanging, return on investment. What studies project will come back if this work's completed?
Close to $500 million that we're going to see in private money that's going to be leveraged.
It would take six to override a promised mayoral veto.
People have been doing backflips to take the operating costs off the city's books. There's a better way forward. I hope that there's room to act on that.
And 30 hours from now, the feds have said they will yank the grant money, and that is the time frame. That is the deadline under which city leaders are operating. That is also the clock that private interests must also live by as they discuss if there's going to be a last-minute savior. Live at City Hall, John London, WLWT News 5.
So two major gatherings tomorrow. The streetcar committee will hear directly from the audit firm, and then the full council expected to render a decision about whether the streetcar survives or stops for good.